diet for endurance athletes, you know, triathletes, marathoners, mm-hmm. you know, these athletes that really need their carbs and need mm-hmm. They need their diet to really help them in their performance. How is it different from the average athlete?
Whether you're an endurance athlete or a hockey player, all these athletes are doing so much training these days that just about everybody's an endurance athlete. Mm-hmm. So the training that they do is always endurance. And it's always a matter of seeing food as fuel, fueling up and refueling. Now, the difference might come in how many calories they take in. If you're running 20 miles, maybe you burn off more than someone who's playing a tennis match. Mm-hmm. But the body can regulate calorie intake if a person listens to their body. Does my body need this food? Yeah, I'm hungry. And like people that are doing a lot of endurance training, they get very hungry. So with any sport, food is fuel, food is important, and too many people say, oh, I don't have time to eat. And if you're an endurance athlete, or if you're a hockey player, if you're a swimmer, if you're a ballerina, I don't have time to eat. You always have time to show up for your training. What do you mean you don't have time to eat?
Yeah.
And I was giving a talk to the Boston College hockey team, and afterwards the coach said, you know, Nancy, these student athletes, they show up for classes, they show up for training, they show up for games, they show up for exams, they show up for quizzes, they show up for homework. They don't show up for food. And you know what? If you don't show up for food, you might as well not show up for any of the other stuff.